Western Zagros is an exploration, development, and production company focused on crude oil and natural gas. Joining me from Western Zagros is CEO Simon Hatfield. Simon, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
You mentioned in your Q4 2012 earnings release that the last year was really a breakthrough year for the company, and you anticipate the remainder of 2013 to build on that success. Can you tell us what's in store for the company this year?
Well, we had tremendous success last year. Our Academy of Two well confirmed for us that in the northern part of our acreage that we have a giant discovery. In fact, right now our contingent resources, which is essentially proven, are just under a billion barrels of oil equivalent. So the Academy of Two was a big success for us. And we're drilling three very high-profile wells this year. We're drilling another step-out well on Kurdemir, that's Kurdemir 3, which is going down very well at the moment. That's going to potentially prove up an additional several hundred million barrels of light oil resources, so we're very excited about that. The well is progressing, it's on time, it's on schedule, so by the middle of the year we should have some news on that. And we're also bringing in, on our southern block, the Garmin block, we're bringing in two new very high-quality drilling rigs. They're being mobilized out of Texas right now to drill two wells, the Baram-1 well, which is right at the northern edge of the block, right where it's right adjacent to the Kurdemir discovery. And that that has the potential of proving up 200 to 300 million barrels on the Garmin block, but also indirectly through about 500 to 600 additional million barrels is an additional 500 to 600 million barrels on the Kurdemir block. So that between the Kurdemir 3 well and the Baram-1 well, we have a lot of exciting news coming. And the second rig that we're bringing in will drill the Hasira-1 well in the southern part of our Garmin block. That's basically an appraisal well from our existing Sarcala discovery. And we hope to have that result by the end of this year as well. So, three very big, high-potential wells, low-risk wells. This is not, although they're, people tend to associate high reward with high risk, but in this case, it's high reward and low risk because they're appraisal wells or they're step-out exploration wells. So, a lot of exciting things to come this year.
I understand you're also seeking a listing on the London Stock Exchange.
Right. Yeah, we've gone a long way applying for that listing. We hope to have that completed in the next couple of months. And we're doing that because it's evident to us that the companies that are active in Kurdistan that are listed on the London Exchange are getting a higher valuation than we currently are listed in Toronto. We're going to keep the Toronto listing. We have a loyal following there. But we are hopeful that once we list in London and we can establish a market for our shares in the London market, that we should see our valuation increase.
What can you tell investors about your current planned operations and drilling activity?
Another one of the questions we get asked quite a bit is why in our current 2013 work program we budgeted for a potential sidetrack in Kurdemir 3. The reason for that is that when you interpret seismic data, the seismic time to depth conversion is not a perfect science. There's always an error range in that. If it so happens that the top of the Oligocene reservoir, which is our main target in Kurdemir 3, comes in a little high and we're a little closer to the gas gap than we thought we would be, in order to prevent a result of the Kurdemir 2 test where we drew gas down from the gas cap into the oil leg, we're prepared with the operator Talisman to sidetrack the well further down dip to get away from the gas cap. So that's the reason for that.
Things seem to be going very well for you. What makes you optimistic about the future, but also what risks are you facing?
Well, another aspect of why I'm so excited about this year is that we just recently closed a couple of finances, which means that we're fully funded for our program this year. And you know, despite some of these challenging economic times, we're very fortunate to have two huge votes of confidence from two major private shareholders. One is Crest International out of Houston, who now own just under 20% of our company, and you know, we completed their financing at a significant premium to market. And we're also very encouraged that out of Singapore, which Chandler Corporation is also participating in the financing to maintain their just over 15% ownership of the company. So it's quite something in these times for us to have an ambitious capital program, but to be fully funded. So we're very pleased about that. Some of the risks we face, I think everybody who follows the situation in Iraq and Kurdistan understands that there's currently a dispute between the Kurdistan regional government and the federal government in Baghdad that's holding up exports from the Kurdistan region. And as a result, our Sarkala well is shut in right now, whereas it could be doing 5,000 barrels a day. And actually, we plan to work over that well later this year and get the production up to about 10,000 barrels a day of light oil. But until the dispute sort of settles down, I think we will be shut in for a while. I know there's negotiations between the Kurdistan regional government and the federal government in Baghdad ongoing, so we're very optimistic that they will resolve the situation. We're also seeing another bright light on the horizon on the political front is the fact that the Turkish government is starting to accept Kurdistan crude for export through Turkey, and we recently had an announcement that Kurdistan crude was sold on the international market via Turkey for the first time. So we're watching that quite closely to see if ultimately we may participate in that. One of the other things that makes me very optimistic, in addition to the fact we're seeing oil trucked out of Kurdistan through Turkey to the export market, we've just seen that started, is that the Kurdistan government has announced that they are building a pipeline to the north of Kurdistan towards the Turkish border to ultimately carry oil directly out of Kurdistan to Turkey. So it doesn't necessarily have to go through the federal Iraqi pipeline system. That's one of the other things that investors should look out for, is the announcement of completion of that pipeline, because that would be a watershed event for us and the first time that there's a pipeline that could export Kurdistan oil directly to Turkey.
Do you see the future for the company as being a listed company, or is there potential to be a bid target?
I think, you know, I get asked that question a lot. I'm aware we're on a lot of other companies' radars. You know, I'd like to see our valuation higher than it is right now. You know, we've received, I would say, a number of informal inquiries about you know, whether we intend to sell the company. We have no intention of selling the company. We have a number. Like I said, we have three, particularly this year, three very high-profile wells we want to drill. And before we even begin to think about something like that, we wish to see the results of those wells.
How will investors be rewarded for the progress that you're making now, and why should investors look at you as an investment opportunity?
I think, you know, one of the things I would urge investors to do is just look at our valuation in terms of our peer group. You know, our actually performance compared to our peer group over the last 2 years has been exceptional. For instance, you know, our share price over the last 2 years has gone up over 60%, right? And we're leading the group, you know, we're ahead of our peer group that also focused on Kurdistan. A couple of things investors should look for, of course, the results of the wells that are coming out, the news flow from them, how our valuation changes once we list on the London Stock Exchange. I want to make that point. We're not going to list on the alternative investment market in the UK. That would be the equivalent of the venture exchange.
Right.
We're actually getting applying for a standard listing on the main board of the London Stock Exchange. And then the other thing, of course, that investors should look at, and I know many of them are, is the political situation in Iraq. Because as soon as the the political situation resolved itself, and Kurdistan starts exporting large amounts of crude, then I believe the discount, a significant discount in our stock will come off.
Simon, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate you being here. Simon Hatfield, CEO of WesternZagros.